Ahora queremos darle una gran, gran bienvenida a nuestro compañero, a nuestro campeón de la reforma migratoria, a nuestra voz, aunque no sea de Oregon, es la voz de muchos de nosotros en este cuarto de hoy. Por favor, que lo escuchen bien, bien fuerte a nuestro compañero Luis Gutiérrez.
Can give for comprehensive immigration reform. one thing clear.
Déjame hacerle algo abundantemente claro a todos.
Yo estoy aquí hoy, pero en el momento que el congresista Walden me pida a mí y que es necesario que yo regrese para estar aquí parado con él en solidaridad con ustedes, me montaré en el primer avión y diré presente.
In the Congress of the United States that we haven't had before.
And then there's even one, there was a majority of Democrats in the House and the Senate.
There was never a majority for comprehensive immigration reform.
Because we just never had the vote.
And I remember Democrats telling me all the time, well, at least if you could find 30 or 40 Republicans to vote for comprehensive immigration reform, we'd put it on the agenda and we'd get it passed. And they were right. A majority of Democrats, but yet not a majority for comprehensive immigration reform.
Let me bring you the good news.
For the first time in my 20 years in the Congress of the United States,
por la primera vez en mis 20 años en el Congreso de los Estados Unidos, existe una mayoría para aprobar una reforma de inmigración.
Paul Ryan and I sat down and talked, and he said to me,
Luis,
we both share a Catholic faith, and that does not allow us to permit and allow in this great nation of ours a permanent underclass of workers that don't receive justice and fairness. And I'm going to work with you to get that done.
There are dozens and dozens of Republicans that want to join Democrats for comprehensive immigration reform.
Hay decenas de republicanos quienes se quieren unir a cientos de demócratas para lograr una reforma. Lo que Boehner, el líder de la Cámara de Representantes, tiene que hacer es llamar un voto y permitir que la democracia florezca en el Congreso de los Estados Unidos.
The New York Times and the Wall Street Journal. Their editorial commentary is identical one to another. Who would have thought?
The AFL-CIO and the U.S. Chamber of Commerce that have never come together before
and signed a joint agreement of understanding on comprehensive immigration reform.
The union organized by Cesar Chavez, the United Farm Workers, has reached an agreement with growers across this country that's included in the Senate version and that I hope to include in the House version.
An agreement between farm workers and their union and growers across this country.
We have conservative evangelicals and Baptists and Catholics and Mormons and Jews and Muslims all coming together at a cemetery. And we saw what happened, didn't we, in the Senate? We saw John McCain join Durbin. We saw Schumer join Lindsey Graham. We saw Senator Rubio join Senator Menendez. Democrats and Republicans. We saw the leader, Harry Reid, in the Senate join together with the minority leader in the Senate. We saw Leahy, the Judiciary Committee chairman, and they all work together. There were a majority of Democrats, but they didn't get a Democratic bill. They didn't get a Republican bill. They got an American bill that solves the problem confronting the United States of America. Así que, sigamos claro.
No es que nosotros estamos insistiendo en una respuesta que sea únicamente respondiendo a cómo es que nosotros vemos el mundo.
No, estamos dispuestos.
Mire, todo el mundo está dispuesto a negociar,
a ir aquí, a un campo en el medio, ¿verdad?
We see many
reaching compromises and bipartisanship to solve America's problems.
The only place it is not happening,
the only place it isn't happening, is in the House of Representatives.
In the House of Representatives, they say to us, we want a majority of Republicans Republicans first to agree before we allow a vote. Well, then you want a minority, then, of members of Congress to dictate the future of our nation. That isn't democracy. It isn't right. Allow a vote of all 435 members of the House of Representatives. And if you do that, because it hasn't been easy, but that's not so fácil. So why do I say, some people say, well, that's Schumer's bill. Well, the only person that believes it's the Schumer bill out of the Senate is Schumer. Everybody else understands that that's a bipartisan bill. And what was given there? I went to the Congress of the United States to advocate for universal health care for anybody as a basic fundamental human right. As a Democrat, yo pienso que universal debe ser que todo el mundo pueda tener. And what did we do with the 11 million in the Senate bill? We said you will not be able to join Obamacare. All subsidies will be denied you. In other words, pay $13,000, $14,000 for a family. We said, no health care for you, 11 million. Then we said to them, pay every tax known at the state and the local and the federal government, but don't expect for 10 years to get one means-tested program.
Paguen todos los impuestos, pero nada del gobierno por 10 años.
Y si eso no fuera suficiente,
and if that wasn't enough, they said, well,
billions of dollars, cientos de millones de dólares, que ustedes aquí en este cuarto y millones como ustedes han contribuido en impuestos de seguro social, billions of dollars contributed to the Social Security Trust Fund, confiscated. You will never be allowed to go back and claim a single cent of the billions of dollars, creating $175 billion
for all of us in this room, $175 billion.
That is the surplus that is created. And if that wasn't enough, they said we want 20,000 more Border Patrol agents. We want 700 miles of fence spent, $40 billion coming out of fines and fees against the undocumented as they legalize to build more fences and to put more Border Patrol agents between us and Mexico. The only other place this is going to be is between North and South Korea. The DMT will probably have more than we have armed forces against one of our enemies at this particular time. But what did we say as Democrats? Did we say no? No. If that is the price that is demanded, and that is where the middle ground exists in American politics, we will pay it in order to allow 11 million people not to be deported from this country to be able to live in harmony with their families and their communities once again. Así que, nosotros no nos pagamos. Y aún insisten en que esto es amnistía. And they continue to insist that this is amnesty. So what do we want to do? We know that the majority of members of the House of Representatives are for comprehensive immigration reform. We've heard the comments, very enlightened comments, of your own congressman, Congressman Walden, where he talked about citizenship for the undocumented. But what we want to make absolutely clear to everyone is this. Lo queremos hacer absolutamente claro a todos. Stop picking winners and losers in the immigration debate, my Republican friends and colleagues. Dejen de estar seleccionando quién va a ganar y quién va a perder. I believe that the high-tech industry that needs more scientists and mathematicians, we should invite new immigrants from around the world to fill that economic vacuum that exists for the high-tech industry. I believe they should come, and we should tell them. But let's be absolutely clear that those that do some of the dirtiest, back-breaking work in America in the fields every day, that make sure that our shelves are full with food, the farm workers of America that work in the fields should be treated equally to those who come here. It is the same. And the economic vitality of one of the largest economic regions of our economy, agriculture.
And why do I say that? Because let's be clear.
You're either going to have your food harvested in foreign land by foreign hands, or have those foreign hands come here to America to harvest it. I say, bienvenido, y el que esté aquí con nosotros haciendo la cosecha, pero con dignidad, y con justicia, y con igualdad de condiciones con todos los demás trabajadores aquí en este país.
So I called Congressman Valadao.
So next week I'll be in Bakersfield. La semana que viene, sábado, estaré en Bakersfield.
De nuevo, más cerca a mi familia extendida ahí.
And there will be a room just like this one. And Congressman Valadao has agreed to join me on the stage so that we can continue to have this conversation. We can continue to reach out to our Republican friends and colleagues so that we can bring an American solution to this issue.
I want to stress that, look, I know many of you say it's a big compromise you make with the others.
It's really a lot that we're giving up. And I simply want you to think a moment. Simplemente quiero que pienses un momento. La urgencia del momento. Hoy va a morir alguien en ese desierto tratando de cruzar a regresar con su familia. Cientos mueren todos los años tratando de regresar a reunificarse con su esposa y con sus hijos. Hoy, tristemente, en algún campo y en alguna fábrica, una mujer inmigrante indocumentada será ultrajada por su patrón. O por otro trabajador. Porque vamos a ser claros, en muchas ocasiones, nosotros mismos somos nuestros peores enemigos cuando viene la explotación de la mujer en nuestras fincas y nuestras fábricas. La corrupción no reconoce barreras étnicas ni lingüísticas. Va a haber alguien que va a perder dedos, manos, ojos, vida hoy por tener que trabajar en condiciones inhumanas y sin regulación. Hoy se van a deportar 1.200 personas. Hoy. Eso quiere decir que 300 niños, 300 American citizen children today, because of the 1,200 deportations that will occur today, will be left without a mom or a dad. Some of them without parents whatsoever today. And it'll happen again tomorrow, and the next day, and the next day, and the next day. Husbands and wives and families will be destroyed. And what are we saying? If that's the price to pay, we will pay to stop the raping of our women, to stop the deaths of the desert, to stop the destruction of our families, and to allow America to once again be the great nation of fairness and justice for all of its immigrants. Ese es el precio, the only place in all of the economic, social areas of American society where people are coming together to reach a compromise in the House of Representatives. And I've come here today and I will continue to raise my voice to say, let democracy reign in the Congress of the United States. It is la Cámara de Representantes, debe ser el hemiciclo del pueblo, y si el pueblo se le permite hablar, nosotros ganamos la lucha ahí. In Washington State this afternoon. I want to say one last thing. Quiero hablarles una cosa a los que creo que es bien importante. Cuando yo hablo con los indocumentados y yo les pregunto qué es lo que quieren, cuál debe ser la meta, ellos me dicen a mí lo siguiente. Luis, queremos nuestros papeles. Quiero esos papeles, esos documentos, para que yo pueda criar a mis hijos sin miedo y temor de ser deportado y separado de ellos. Quiero, Luis, prosperar con mi esposa y poder ir a trabajar y vivir con ella una vida llena. Y aunque los papeles y el tratamiento no sea el tratamiento más justo, Luis, mis hijos y los hijos de mis hijos se encargarán para bregar con ellos que me han tratado de una manera mala, que me han tratado con crueldad, que me han tratado con injusticia. Pero Luis, tú tienes que parar las deportaciones, tú tienes que parar la división de nuestras familias. Yo necesito que tú me pongas a mí como tú pondrías a tu esposa si estaría en peligro, y a tus hijos si estarían en peligro, en un sitio seguro, en un sitio donde no tienen que temer, en un sitio donde ya no le pueden hacer daño. Esa es la reforma abarcadora del sistema de inmigración. Y eventualmente nosotros, no es que a mí me guste negociar con republicanos, yo no fui al Congreso a hacer eso. De hecho, fui a pelear con ellos, más que negociar. But I've learned, we've all learned, I think we've all grown and we've all matured, that if you're going to look for solutions, you have to work with people who don't see the world the way you see it, and find commonality in your vision. Así que, yo voy a continuar las negociaciones con ellos, y yo voy a continuar elaborando este plan, y eventualmente nosotros vamos a regresar. Ustedes tienen que estar listos para su respuesta. Ustedes tienen que estar listos para su respuesta. The last thing I'm going to say is to the growers, we need you. We need you more than ever. I can fill rooms like this across this country. We can march by the hundreds of thousands, we can march by the millions. But what we need is those that are the owners of the economic engine, the growers in our agriculture, to sit down with your friends in the Republican Party, your friends that you talk to, that share your values and share your goals of prosperity, sit down with them and say, for my own, so that all my parents can be picked, so that all my carriers can be picked. Luis says he will provide us with all of the new workers we need if there aren't enough here in this country already. But first we have to treat those that are here readily, well, and then we can bring new growth forward to this country. And to bring it. But I say to you, I'm going to be here, I'm going to go out to one of your farms. I'm going to go visit. I understand he has 700 people picking and 500, and I'm going to go. Because I think that's important, that I not only be here, but that I see and smell and that I get a real thing. So I can go back to the so that I can go back. I am for Ag Jobs Bill that gives you every worker that you need to make sure that your economic strength is demonstrated each and every day and strengthened as we move forward. But if we're going to get it done, we're going to have to get it done for everybody. For those that we invite coming new to our country, but for those that are already here and have roots in the United States of America. Mañana por la mañana. Zoraida, mi esposa, sabía que cuando yo partía anoche, que yo iba a regresar a la casa. Y déjame decirle a ustedes, yo no voy a descansar hasta que todo esposo tenga la misma seguridad de cuando sale a trabajar, va a regresar a su esposa. Que todo esposo tenga la misma seguridad que tiene el mío. Cuando ella salga a trabajar, que sus esposos estarán ahí. No voy a descansar hasta que todos los hijos de América tengan el mismo conocimiento y identidad, ¿verdad?, que tienen mis hijas, que cuando su mamá y su papá salen, van a regresar a su casa al final de su día laboral. Porque aquí estamos entre aquellos que quieren negarnos un futuro y aquellos que demandamos justicia. Yo amo a mi prójimo como a sí mismo. Yo tengo derecho y tengo protección.
millones. Yo quiero